Hi everyone, this is Aki with another quick video on how to create a book cover in Keynote. So when you go to Barnes & Noble or Amazon, you know, for Amazon KDP, they have them specifications and about when you import your PDF cover. And you know, I've had some problems with, you know, from the ones that I was creating Canva. So I was looking for some other options, and for Barnes and Noble Press, they also have this requirement that you have to embed fonts. So Canva was not doing it for me. So I actually tried to replicate this, my cover that I've designed in Canva, in Keynote. So let me show you how to do that. So when you open in a Keynote presentation, now you want to make sure that this is going to be sized to the size of your cover. So I went on, you know, KDP, Amazon, and I used their cover template generator, which basically, you know, shows you provide this information: how big is your book, what kind of paper you want to use, how many pages, and then you can download the template. So I already have my template, and let me show you right there. Here is my template. So this is a PDF. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to actually go to Keynote. Before I do that, I have to set up my Keynote to the size of the template. So this is my template, and right now it's telling me that the size, the dimensions are 15.29. Let me just write it down because I will need that. Times 10.25 inches overall dimension. That includes front, spine, and back. So I need to set up my Keynote that size because I will, you know, convert this to PDF and then import it to Barnes & Noble or Amazon as my cover. So right now, if you go to Format, the top, and go to, Document, and now scroll down to slide size, it tells me it's 16 by 9. That does not tell me anything really, how size it is, how big it is when I'm going to convert to PDF. So I click the custom slide size, and here it's telling me how many points I want to set my size, slide size. And I don't know what kind of points. So I actually have another video about how to do the calculations, but I have an Excel file where I do the calculation. You can do it manually or you can use the file. And I know in inches, I just checked that I wanted to do it. The size would be width of 15.29 and height of 10.250. And that converts for me to 1188 points times 738. So that's when I have to enter this information in my Keynote slide size. So I'm going to enter this, and 738, and click OK. So now it should be sized exactly to my cover. So I'm going to use, let me show you what you can do. You just can grab the PDF that you have downloaded from Amazon or Barnes & Noble, because they also have a template to generate a template. And you see it's exactly fits perfectly for my slide size. Now, what I like to do, you will notice how I usually duplicate the slide, just so if I mess up, I don't have to start over. So I created a new slide, and this time I'm going to actually change the opacity of this. So I'm going to go to Format, make it less dark, so it's like light, so I can work on top of it. And now, so it doesn't move, what you want to do is go to Arrange in the top right, and you want to lock it. So once it's locked, I won't have the situation where I'm moving things around, the background also is moving. So once I have that, I actually am going to do one more thing. So I'm going to actually duplicate this. And now here I have a cover that I did in Canva. And this is the cover that I had, but it was rejected. and didn't have embedded fonts. So I'm going to import this in my Keynote. So I go back to my Keynote, find a file, and you can use JPEG or you can do PDF. So I'm going to take my cover and put it in Keynote again. And it should fit exactly the same because I sized my Canva to the same size. So this is what it is. This is my book cover. Now, I also want to make sure I change the opacity because I am going to be working on top of it. But this kind of helps me to see. You see these, you know, the red areas where it says, you know, you shouldn't have any text or images in that area, and otherwise the cover will be rejected. So I can see what's going on. Later on, you want to remove this when it's finalized, but during the working progress, I keep it that way. And I'm going to also lock it, and I'm going to make a duplication just so later on I have the working copy where I'll be able to remove everything. Now, what happened is that sometimes, you know, in your, now I'm ready to work, right? I have my template from Amazon or Barnes & Noble, and then I have my book cover that I kind of created and I want to replicate in Keynote. And now I'm able to basically put all these texts and create. Now I want to mention another tip for you. So some of the fonts that I've used in Canva, like this big one that I liked, I didn't have originally in Keynote. So what you can do is basically try to find a free version, and then once you have that that font, like I had this League Spartan Bold that I was interested in having, you can just download it, double click, and then it will open your font book and you can install this font. And once it's installed, you're able to use it in Keynote. So this is like a tip for you. So let me just show you, just to get you started, but obviously you can do a work on your cover differently. So now I can't see the menu for format. Why? Because I don't have any text or anything. So I want to enter some text. So I'm clicking the text box, and now once I have that, now I have the menu for the font and so on. So let me just show you. I'm going to put boost, and I'm going to actually do each of the text separately. The reason why, because then you have to make sure that the lines separate the same way and they might not be. So it's just easier to do word by word. I mean, in your case, is some of the section obviously not, but the big title. So now I'm going to select my font that I downloaded, League Spartan, and I'm going to just size it. Let's say that, that's not what I want, 40. Okay, so now I can see that it's still small. So I just try to line up how I have it, and I'm going to try to increase it until it shows or lines up over the text that I had before, to kind of match what I had before. Okay, let's try to do 80, maybe 90. I'm just going to show you a couple of it, and then you get an idea how this works. So it's still not perfect. So let's do 100. And okay, so now when I, you know, it's pretty much the same time, but you can see that it doesn't line up exactly because maybe the spacing between the letters is different. So there's a format option here, advanced options, and you can select the character spacing. So I can just increase the character spacing and try to line it up this way, and so on. So you basically can do that. And then, you know, if you have this, like certain areas that are blocked out, you can just do shapes and then, you know, put that in and put text over it. Text. And so let's say, put say sample text. And I'm going to change the font so I can see it on the background. and you know, you can change the font again to look Spartan. Usually the font that you've used in the past, it will show up at the very top. And you can just do 30, let's say. And so you can line up and you just work through what you have had in your on your book cover to kind of get you an idea. And like the little check marks, these are shapes, so maybe you can search for check mark, and you know, you can change the size and so on, colors. If you have something that you don't have a shape in, you can just import it. Like I have a logo right there, so I would just in that case go to media and then choose and find the location of that item and just import it. So hopefully this helps you, you know, get an idea how to create a book cover in Keynote as an alternative to other programs, since if you have a Mac, it's already free on your operating system. So thanks for watching.